Hi, Andrew. My name is Khurshid. I'm from Uncle K Live TV and Radio. And as I said, we are broadcasting from Dubai about Dubai, the exhibitions and the people who are coming here. Yeah. And because mostly this is agriculture, this is showing the taste of Dubai. But when we go to the supermarket, we never know who are the suppliers or where these things are coming. Except for Carrefour type of supermarkets, where at least they write the country or origin of it. Most of the places you don't know the origin also. You know, Afghani things get mixed with Iranian things and
yes.
So tell me, when, since you are from USA, so they must be doing a good job that these people are sitting here today. Instead of the rumors we hear on the news, there's fighting and blasting, whether it's Pakistan, whether it is this thing. But today, USAID is sitting with them and they're doing their business here. So what's the story behind this?
Oh, basically, I guess USAID are investing into Afghanistan to assist the people of Afghanistan to rebuild the country. So over the last 10 years, they've done a lot of work in planting orchards and developing the agricultural sector. And as things have gone, those trees and everything have grown significantly, and now we're having increased volumes of fruit and vegetables to send to export markets as well as for local consumption. So
I think that's a big achievement, because a country where they would, you know, out of grudge destroy the other person's crops.
Yes.
How did you pacify those people? That was something wondering.
Well, I guess that's part of it. If by lifting the economy, it's certainly helping with the peace process as well. So giving people a real alternative. And and what we're finding too is that the people in places like Dubai and India and that are very passionate about the fruits from Afghanistan. So selling to these markets is quite good, because the people want to buy Afghanistan produce.
No, I agree with you, because export is the only thing which makes a country grow.
Yeah.
Like tourism. Tourism is inward and export is outward. And you people standing there, I'm not a politician, I don't care what is happening in the world, it's nothing to do with me. You and I sitting here have no enmity against each other.
Yeah.
In fact, if we can just by this word of mouth spread peace and maybe give them some idea to see what is happening across the border of that country.
Sure.
So you people have taken the risk to be there, being in the war front. It's a very dangerous place to be in.
Yeah.
And then to make them grow these things, I am admiring. And this shows that nature works in its own mysterious ways.
Yeah.
So, you know, there is ups and downs, and
sure.
People, they have to learn the hard way. And then when the will is there to grow, then people like you come and give them a helping hand.
Yeah.
You cannot pull up somebody who doesn't want to be pulled up.
No, for sure.
So anything else you know? Are you an agriculturist?
Yes.
You are from a consulting company?
Roots of Peace have been in Afghanistan for over 10 years, and they started by actually clearing the landmines out of the fields.
Okay, that's how you entered there.
Yeah, so
okay.
And then once the landmines were cleared, then they were planting vines and trees, and now 10 years on, we're helping market those products to overseas
markets.
Wasn't
that a change for your company, going from landmine sweeping to...
That's what their organization does. So they do it right around the world, and Afghanistan is where they're being.
I mean, I've heard of innovation. You have to change according to time, but your company from minesweeping went to agriculture. That's surprising.
Yeah.
So, Andrew, thank you very much.
Thank you.
I just wanted to introduce the phase of USAID into this.
No, that's fine.
And you are doing a good job.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Right.
Okay, bye.